Hey everybody, this is Janice Mansfield here, and I am pleased, excited, and honored to be co-hosting the February 2nd Cookalong with Shanae Robinson. And as for those of you who have already signed up for it, you might know that we're doing gluten-free pies of all kinds. In my opinion, the world does not have enough savory pies, so we're out to rectify that, and we're going to give you an option for making a really tasty gluten-free one that even your wheat-loving friends will find really delicious. I can guarantee that. And so I thought that I would do a little bit of a demo. We're set up really crudely here in my messy kitchen today. And so we're just going to run through from start to finish, hopefully all in one take, because Jeffrey's out chopping wood and doing other assorted and sundry things. So we've got the webcam set up, and I've got the food processor set up, and I'm just going to run through sort of what I think is the easiest way to make this particular pie crust. So here we go. We have a few things. We have some amaranth flour, and if you don't have amaranth flour, you could use brown rice flour. Just make sure it's really finely milled. We have cornstarch and we have tapioca starch. Those are the three flours we're going to be using. And we have some xanthan gum and some baking powder, some salt, a little bit of sugar. I like to use just a little bit of granulated sugar in my gluten-free pie crust just because it helps with the binding and the browning. With everything, just I prefer the texture of it, but you can certainly omit it. I've done it without. And we have an egg, and again, I've done it with and without egg, both equally as successfully. It is a little better texture. The addition of the extra fat and the binding of the egg whites does help a lot with the texture of the final product, but it's not a make or break. I've made perfectly acceptable and delicious pie crusts without it. So the other thing that's an optional that I find adds to the texture is a little bit of baking powder. And again, if you're making this for your celiac friends who can't tolerate gluten, even in trace amounts, make sure that you use products that are not contaminated. Don't buy your flours from bulk food bins. Buy them from processors where you know that they are manufacturing safely and that they're testing their products. There's a few good manufacturers out there. Bob's Red Mill is one that makes a lot of good products and has a separate dedicated facility, but there are others out there. So I think I've listed links for a couple of them on the oats front as well in the blog post that I wrote. So here we go. We're going to set this up and hopefully do it in one take. And I'm going to do a 2/3 portion here, only because my food processor is a little on the small side. So if you are in the same position of, this is about a 9-cup Cuisinart machine. So by all means, do the same thing with yours. And I'm getting stares from Kimmy, going, what are you doing? So we're gonna do 2/3 of a cup of flour of each one of these. And I'm just going to scoop and level and dump it into the food processor as we go. So it's 2/3 of a cup of tapioca. And 2/3 of a cup of amaranth. And for this, you could use brown rice flour as well. And we're going to leave this out because we're going to use that for rolling the pastry out with. And 2/3 of a cup of cornstarch. So that is it for the flours. So I think in the recipe I posted online, it's 1 cup of each. So I just cut that down by 2/3. So I'm going to put in 1 teaspoon into this batch of salt, sea salt. And in the recipe, I believe it calls for 1.5 teaspoons. And I'm going to put about 1 teaspoon, or 1 tablespoon rather, of granulated sugar. Baking powder, and this one is from Bob's Red Mill. It's a double acting baking powder and gluten free. One of the few double acting baking powders out there. And a tablespoon of xanthan gum. So you'll notice I keep this sealed in the bag. If it gets wet at all, it's a huge slimy mess. So you want to keep it watertight. And I don't have the lid, so just, you know, that. So I have the blade in here, and we're just going to pulse this to mix all the dry ingredients. We were doing this by hand with a pastry blender. You would whisk this in a bowl. Now we're going to add the fat. And I'm going to do this in 2 stages, and I'm using Earth Balance shortening here. This is soy based. I find the coconut ones a little too soft. You could certainly use butter. Butter works just fine too. So if you're not dairy, if you're not avoiding dairy, by all means, use butter. This particular shortening is vegan. So I'm going to save the last 1/4 cup of this, and we're going to put in 3/4 cup, so 1.5 sticks, cut into pieces. We're going to pulse this. So it's fairly fine. And we're going to put in the last 1/4 cup. So we're just trying to achieve 2 different sizes of chunks here, really. That's it for the dry ingredients. And for the liquid, I'm going to add an egg. So I'm just going to whisk it. This is a large egg. Let's get to mix it. And we're going to add that in. And you can see that comes together. That's actually a bit moist. That might have been an extra large egg, so I'm going to add maybe a couple of tablespoons of amaranth flour to this mix. We don't want this too dry, but you do want it dry enough to be able to work it. Okay. So you can see in here, that's what it looks like. And I can touch it. And it's a little bit sticky, but it doesn't get all over my hands. So our next step is going to be rolling this out. Now you could bundle this up if you wanted to. In plastic wrap. Or not. And let it sit in the fridge, but you can actually successfully roll it out straight away. And if you're doing this for the first time, I would recommend actually just taking off small amounts. And you can actually knead it a little bit as you go. It kind of gets the xanthan gum going. You want it activated, but you don't want it as fully activated as if you're making bread. And I'm going to try and zoom in here. So let's just see if we can do this successfully. We go. So you can see here I have a silpat liner. This is a lot easier to do if you don't have a silpat liner, or if you do have a silpat liner. If you don't, you can put a layer of plastic wrap down on your counter.